गाइस वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल बंसल बायोलॉजी। आज हमारे साथ है अभय दीप फ्रॉम आरसीबी। सो थैंक यू सो मच अभय अब टाइम निकालने के लिए बंसल बायोलॉजी के लिए।
थैंक यू अवंतिका।
एंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अभय आई वुड लाइक कि आप अपने आप को इंट्रोड्यूस करिए ताकि बंसल बायोलॉजी के स्टूडेंट्स आपको जान सके।
सो हेलो एवरीवन, सो माय नेम इज अभय दीप पांडे एंड आई एम अ थर्ड ईयर पीएचडी स्टूडेंट इन हियर इन आरसीबी Regional Center for Biotechnology, Faridabad. So I have joined a special program called PhD program in Biostatistics and Bioinformatics, which is supported by GSK, GlaxoSmithKline Pharmaceuticals. And yeah, that's it for the introduction.
So Abhay, can you tell us that how to apply for RCB, that how we can apply?
So for the application process, it's very simple that you have to follow the advertisement in RCB website, and as per the eligibility criteria, you can choose your area of
interest. Yes.
Application. Uh-huh. Yeah, application. So there are three programs currently RCB is running. One is integrated PhD program, and one is regular PhD program, mm-hmm. and there is another this GSK supported PhD program.
Okay.
So you can choose, and so in general PhD program there are you will have a two time means application, like in one in January and one in July.
Okay.
And then for the integrated there is only one call for application, and for this biostatistics and bioinformatics program there is only one call in a year.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you have told us that there are three options: integrated PhD, PhD. So what are the difference between these three? Can you tell the students?
Yeah. So I will start with the integrated PhD program. So in integrated PhD program, students after BSc they can join this program. So they have to follow the again the same process for the application, and then there will be means a personal interview also.
Okay.
This time, like this in COVID situation, they are means everything is online only, and after that, they will be means provided a proper lab, and they will do the MSc also, and simultaneously they will do the research work.
Okay.
From the means the as a so in the fourth semester they will do the dissertation, and they can choose their own their lab based on their interest, and if they want to pursue the PhD in the same area, they can continue with the same lab. Otherwise, they can change that their labs.
Okay.
So, and second option is normal PhD program. So if you have any fellowship like ICMR, DBT fellowship for 5 years, so again there will be a call for application. You have to join that means you have to apply for that. Then you can come for the interview after the shortlisting process. Then again there will be interview, and then you will be given particular labs, and then you can continue your PhD.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the third, you have told one more.
Yeah, so third is the exciting one, because I was the one who got this opportunity to do the PhD in this particular area.
Okay.
So this is started, I think, 3 or 4 years back when GSK and RCB have had some memorandum, and then they have decided like, okay, GSK will fund some set of students, like initially it was two uh-huh. for bioinformatics and two for biostatistics.
Okay.
So they will and there are some other institute also like IIT Delhi, NII, NIBNG Kolkata.
Uh-huh.
So so collectively all these 4 or 5 institutes they came forward, and they decided like, okay, for the biostatistics NIBNG will take care of the students. They will do the means the registration will be in RCB only, but there all the research work will be conducted in NIBMG.
Okay.
And for the bioinformatics students have option to choose either RCB, NII, IIT Delhi and ICGEB. So means they can choose PI from there, means there are selected PIs, they are part of this program so they will the student can choose PI from these institutes,
mm-hmm.
and they can conduct their PhD research work over there also. And some of them, like me, means I have chosen RCB only, so I'm doing my research program here. So why this is exciting? Because this is very, very competitive, means like a fellowship program. So there are only two seats for bioinformatics first, but the fellowship is little better than other fellowship programs. Like means we get for initial 2 years we get 45,000 rupees plus accommodation. Okay. After 2 years we'll get 50,000 rupees plus accommodation.
So
that is why this is a very exciting and very means competitive also.
So how to apply?
So student can choose.
So how to apply for this?
So the process is same.
Like
you will so आपको advertisement follow करना है. उसमें फिर आपको उसके हिसाब से application details आपको डालने होते हैं and then they will first so for the this bioinformatics program एक written test भी होता है because there is no need of having NET and GATE or any other fellowship eligibility exams. Yeah. So without NET GATE also you can apply for this program. So the competition is again very high. So then there will be a very kind of tough written exam, and after that they will select top means based on the requirement. Like sometimes they will choose on top 10, sometimes only top 5, and then there will be interview. Yeah, based on the interview, they will against shortlist only 2 people. So it's not mandatory that they will they have to choose 2 or means 1. If there is no student means found like a competent like eligible or they are not showing the means their interest is not towards science, just they have cracked the exam, so they won't choose anyone. So they will keep the seat vacant, but they won't choose a wrong person. Wrong, this is a very tough word. So similarly you have to be very focused and science oriented.
Yes.
To be in, to apply for this. Yeah.
So अबे आपने मुझे अभी बताया कि ये जो exam होता है बहुत competitive होता है. So it is competitive like it is more tougher than CSI or NET also.
Actually, I can't say that. Means every exam have their own.
But like what is the pattern like means, GATE like MCQ of 1 marks or the long
MCQ.
MCQ, but how are the MCQ section of CSIR NET or B section?
So actually, I'll explain this way. So this program is typical bioinformatics program, or biostatistics program. So most of the time they will have bioinformatics oriented questions.
Okay.
Computational questions like a technical questions. Like so I can't say it's means CSI or DBT because there are a very less number of question you will have from bioinformatics section, but here most of the question will have from the bioinformatics background. So and the competitive in the sense like there are only 2 seats. So and again there is no need of having any eligibility test clear. So that is why people who have experience they apply for this program. So you have to compete with them. Like the people have applied like with the 2 year, 3 year, 4 year, 5 year of experience, they can also apply. So yeah, so this is a very good opportunity for those who are thinking like okay, somehow they missed the NET exams and they want to again pursue research, they can come here and join this program. And one of the example of the same case.
So only if they want to pursue in bioinformatics or biostatics, right?
Yes.
And for this, does it mean that they have MSc in bioinformatics or biostatics?
So initially, when for the first 2 years, they had this criteria also. Like if you have a background like MSc in bioinformatics, then only you can apply. Okay. But later on, we have seen that they have removed this criteria. If you have interest and you have a knowledge of bioinformatics also from any stream, you can join your join this program. But biostatistics, it's I think it's still the same. You have to have a master's in biostatistics.
And if someone wants to pursue like regular PhD, okay, the second option, the regular PhD. So RCB उसके लिए भी कोई अलग से एग्जाम लेता है और नॉट
नहीं एक्चुअली इसमें क्या है कि आपने एप्लीकेशन प्रोसेस फॉलो किया और अब मैंने अभी तक 2-3 साल में तो नहीं देखा कि दोबारा एग्जाम होते हैं, बट वो आपके एप्लीकेशन प्रोसेस रिसर्च इंटरेस्ट को देख के वो एक शॉर्ट लिस्ट करते हैं. सो सपोज मींस योर रिसर्च इंटरेस्ट इज टोटली डिफरेंट, विच आरसीबी डोंट हैव मींस द फैसिलिटी इन आरसीबी ओनली, सो दे वोंट चूज दोज एप्लीकेशंस. सो बिफोर अप्लाइंग यू हैव टू हैव अ क्लियर कट आइडिया दैट विच टाइप ऑफ रिसर्च यू आर इंटरेस्टेड इन and whether that research is the research area is the part of the RCB or not. So that way you can pursue. Yeah.
So can you tell us what kind of questions are asked in interview, if you know about regular questions?
So means we have friends here. So after discussing their interview questions, so most of the time people will ask you. Means suppose I am the PI and I need a person with a particular background. So I will make sure that ki jo bachcha mujhe join kare usko wo cheeze pata hu. So sometime you means preparation don't means doesn't matter here. So you have to have some set of skills if you want to join that particular lab. But in my case, what happened, like when I entered in the interview room. So they asked me about my means. First of all, like explain your research interest, yourself, then your research means history, like what you have done and what was your means MSc dissertation. So they started from the dissertation questions, and then again the same thing. Like this is a bioinformatics PhD program, so sara kuch. सेंटर था बायोइनफॉर्मेटिक्स के क्वेश्चन से हिसाब से. और इन माय एप्लीकेशन वी हैव रिटन अ रिसर्च इंटरेस्ट अ वन पेज राइटर. सो दे जस्ट ग्रिल्ड मी ऑन दैट, लाइक ईच एंड एवरी लाइन दे विल दे वांट मी टू एक्सप्लेन. सो मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम आई मींस आई वाज एबल टू एक्सप्लेन बिकॉज इट वाज माय इंटरेस्ट. एंड या सो दिस वे आई मींस फेस दैट इंटरव्यू. बट some other friends, they said ki like they didn't ask any question from my dissertation. Again the same, like the particular PI will ask question from their background, their lab's background, and sometime in general question they will ask you like, okay, you have some basic skills or not.
So
for the MSc that MSc integrated PhD program, they can't expect you to be a means like a pro. So they will ask you the from basic question, and they will judge you on the basis of like you whether you have that motivation and that focus in thoughts or not. So yeah, so means you have to be very clear about the science you want to do, and very clear about what you know.
What you know and what you have done in your dissertation, that must be also.
Don't pretend.
Don't pretend. Okay. So how many rounds of interview have gone through? Like 1, 2, how many rounds?
Mostly only one interview round, but there will be like a very huge panel. Sometime minimum I have seen like 4 to 5 people will be there, and then it can exceed to like 10, 20. So sometime like, you know, they will means conduct the interview based on the research interest also. Like first, like, okay, suppose somebody is interested in cancer biology. So means all the PI from the cancer biology, they have the vacancy under means in that lab, they will come in the panel, and they will means interview only those students who have seen shown their interest in cancer biology. Suppose the same for the virology, so the virology people will come. So this way, so they will segregate PIs and then they will interview you.
So you have written research proposal also for this?
Yes. So not quite like in the starting. I have written the research interest first. So based on that research interest, I got my PI of choice. And then we discussed a lot, like which part of their lab's work I can do, and which suits my experience and which suits the motive of this program also.
Okay.
So then we have written a synopsis for the PhD, And after the coursework, we have started doing these things. Yeah.
So can you guide students how to write the research proposal in, like, if you can explain?
Research proposal, if I'm getting it right, it will come after your selection.
Okay.
But research interest, you have to write before, for the application.
Okay.
So research interest, most of the time, you should not fake your interest.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever you have, because in the interview, they are very, very smart. The PIs are very smart. They will ask you one question and you are gone. They will know that you are faking it. So write what you know, write what you are willing to pursue based on your previous knowledge.
Okay.
Write what you find in that particular lab. Suppose you have chosen one's lab and you know that, okay, means if I want to join RCB, I want to join these two labs, or these means either this lab or that lab.
Okay.
So very, your thought should be very clear, like, okay, means my research interest, my experience, and everything will sum up to target that lab.
Okay.
So you can change your research lab based on research interest based on the different labs.
Oh.
Because I suppose my experience was initially I was doing the data analysis like RNA-seq and genomics, but in this program, because of it is a GSK funded. So I was very clear that they will look for a candidate who also can do drug designing or drug discovery part.
Okay.
So based on my previous experience, I formulated my research interest this way that, okay, I know all these things, but I want to pursue these things.
Okay.
So that way I have formulated my research interest.
Okay, great. Apart from that, Abhay, if any student have no research experience, nothing, no dissertation, like many institutes present have dissertation also. So what should they do if they want to pursue PhD?
If you don't have any kind of experience after MSc, you want to pursue PhD. So my suggestion would be first target labs, your research area.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I want to do this kind of research based on whatever study you had, and try to interact with the people from that lab or PI directly. So most of the time PI will answer your question through mail also.
And
you can ask in every MSc program they used to have some hands-on also. So the hands-on you are doing, you should have very, very good command on it. So after that you can join any lab as a JRF, okay? Or you can join any a project associate, something like that, or JRF, project JRF, you can join that and gain some experience.
Okay.
Based on, and simultaneously prepare for the NET and other fellowship program.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can wait and prepare for the fellowship program and just crack, get any of those and then apply for the PhD. So these two ways you can choose. Or another option you have, if you want to gain some experience before applying for any kind of PhD program, you can choose a DBT program for the training.
Okay.
So there is, after MSc, there is a DBT program for training. So industrial training, actually.
Okay.
So they will choose you and they will allot you a company or a research lab.
Mm-hmm.
And in that lab, you can train yourself or get the exposure and you will get a stipend of 8,000 rupees, I guess. So currently, last time I checked, it was 8,000 rupees. So these three ways you can choose and you can continue as a researcher.
So for DBT, when the application forms are released?
I don't remember the date. Yeah, but you have to check it. You can check it from a previous years. What time it was out. So I don't have that.
No problem. Yes.
Date. Yeah.
So can you tell us about your research also, if that's possible?
My research topic is computational drug designing method to identify the possible inhibitor against JEV, Japanese encephalitis virus.
Okay.
And I'm in that research interest, research proposal. I have four objective. One is like to create a database of means phytochemicals which can inhibit GAV, and then perform the ADME analysis, and then in silico means screening of those against JVNS5 protein.
Okay.
And then I'm also targeting the structural region of JV with the same process. And then I have to validate all the results. And then hopefully I'm done.
It's a huge research. It's feeling like it's a huge
research. Yeah.
That's great. Yeah. Okay. Apart from that, Abhay, can you tell us about RCP? Like students who don't know about RCP. So how's RCP?
So... RCB is a DBT institute, Regional Center for Biotechnology. So the means along with the DBT, there is a role of UNESCO. So it is a part of UNESCO's program to train, to provide the human resource and to train people in science. So it's a typical RCB UNESCO blending, and then it's a primary focus of RCB is to provide the world-class education, that is for sure. And then a training, conduct the innovative research. And yeah, so there are all these things are in RCB. And apart from that, we have a very means good culture of research here. You can interact any PI, you can interact any student, you can visit any lab anytime and use any instrument with the protocol. And yeah, so this is a very healthy atmosphere here.
So these are the perks of RCP also, you can say that.
Yeah, there are many other perks also.
Can you tell us about them also?
Yeah, so RCP is a part of means DBT cluster program.
Okay.
So if you are joining the RCP, you have a connection with the other 3-4 institute surrounding in NCR plus.
Okay.
So that is why this area, I mean, the campus known as NCR Biotech Science Cluster. So this is a means RCB is situated in this cluster. So there is another institute parallel to this RCB in the same campus, that is THSTI, Translational Health and Science Technology Institute. So that the major perk is this: if you are joining RCB, you have a fair chance to interact with the THSTI. Scientist also.
Okay.
Apart from that, there is a ATPC, like Advanced Technology Platform Center. So you have all the means high-end equipments here in ATPC. You can use them as a student of RCB. You have a very nominal rates. Like you have, you'll get some discount also to use them. And apart from ATPC, there is a BB, means this Bio Incubator Center. So here, companies, means if you have any startup idea, you can directly go and talk, talk to the incubator people, and they will guide you how you can translate your research program, idea to a startup, and how you can monetize your idea. So this is major perk. Like having a ATPC, having a bio incubator in the same campus, another institute in the same campus. So you have a huge opportunity if you are joining RCB here as a PhD.
Yes, you can interact with a lot number of people and PIs. Yes.
Yeah, we have common cafeteria for all these four centers.
Okay.
So every time you'll visit cafeteria, you will see all the people who are doing the startups, people who are doing the research, postdoc people, means there are many area they cover here in RCB. So yeah, that is means I like that environment here. So I can actually go to
working environment. Yes.
Okay. Yeah. So I can. This is the answer for your question also. I can enter any lab anytime, and I can interact. So you can assume like how friendly atmosphere here in RCB. And same way, I can go to that bio incubator and I can interact any startup people over there. Like they have informed us like around 30 to 35 companies right now it's running here. So they are starting. Yeah, so that is a very huge number. So you have 35 options, right? Means for, from day you are joining RCB, you can go and employment option is also increasing the same way. You can go interact them like and see like, okay, with this research, whether I can join them or not in coming 5 or 6 years. So these kind of atmosphere we are seeing it here in RCB.
So with this comes my another question also. What after PhD? Like generally students are confused. Okay, if we have done our PhD, what we have to do next?
So yeah, this is daily basis we are discussing the same thing. So
yes.
problem kya hoti hai ki कुछ स्टूडेंट्स जो हैं पीएचडी को डेस्टिनेशन मान के बैठते हैं कि गेटिंग पीएचडी इज देयर डेस्टिनेशन. दैट इज रॉन्ग.
ओके,
गेटिंग पीएचडी इज जस्ट एन ऑप्शन आफ्टर पीएचडी. सो दिस इज माय लाइन आई यूज्ड टू टेल मींस अदर फ्रेंड्स आल्सो, लाइक पीएचडी जर्नी नॉट द डेस्टिनेशन. सो यू स्टार्ट योर रिसर्च जर्नी फ्रॉम द पीएचडी, एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू बी इन रिसर्च यू कंटिन्यू विद द स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड द रोड.
Okay.
PhD, postdoc, and then if you're good in research, then you can come back and write a proposal and you can continue in the research.
Okay.
But some people, like a very less number of people from RCB, I have seen, like they also join the industry.
Okay.
Same way. Like I have a clear option that I can join industry because I'm a part of industrial PhD program.
Okay.
So I have that liberty that I, after PhD, means I can join industry directly.
Okay.
Yes.
So these are the two main options. After that, assistant professor. That's another option.
Yeah. No, that and third option I told you, na, that by incubator you will start your your own business.
Your own.
Like,
okay.
Yeah. So you have to be very clear about your thoughts. Like otherwise you will be confused in after doing PhD also. So say similar situation. You will have. बस आपके नाम क्या है डॉक्टर लग जाएगा but. आपके पास अगर आपके थॉट्स क्लियर नहीं है तो आप वहीं के वहीं हो.
वहीं के वहीं, बिल्कुल सही. एंड अबे आप कुछ मैसेज देना चाहेंगे स्टूडेंट्स को जो कि अभी एमएससी में है, बीएससी सब स्टूडेंट्स देख रहे हैं, जो क्राउड है वो बीएससी का भी है, एमएससी का भी है, और ऐसे स्टूडेंट्स जो एमएससी पास आउट है, तो उन सबके लिए अगर आप कुछ मैसेज देना चाहें किस तरीके से वो प्लान करें अपनी चीजें इफ दे वॉन्ट टू डू पीएचडी ऑब्वियसली.
सो यस, सो फॉर द बीएससी स्टूडेंट, अगर आपको पीएचडी करनी है तो आपको आपकी प्रिपरेशन एमएससी से स्टार्ट करनी पड़ेगी. सो इन एमएससी व्हाटएवर यू आर डूइंग डू इट वेरी सीरियसली. जो पढ़ना है अच्छे से पढ़ना है, जो सीखना है बहुत अच्छे से सीखना है, और उसके बाद चूज योर प्रोग्राम्स. लाइक दिस काइंड ऑफ प्रोग्राम यू कैन चूज, लाइक इंटीग्रेटेड पीएचडी, दे आर वन ऑफ द फाइनेस्ट लाइक प्रोग्राम्स हियर इन इंडिया. सो इसमें आपको फेलोशिप भी मिलती है, एमएससी में प्रॉपर फेलोशिप मिलती है और हाई एंड ट्रेनिंग मिलती है, और आप मतलब समझिए पीएचडी स्टूडेंट के साथ आप काम कर रहे होते हैं एमएससी में. सो दिस इज लाइक अ ग्रेट फीलिंग. मींस हियर आई हैव इंटरेक्टेड विद द एमएससी स्टूडेंट आल्सो. सो वो हमेशा कहते हैं कि ऐसा एटमोसफियर मतलब हमें अपने सीनियर से कभी सुनने नहीं मिलता था, बट हम वो देख रहे हैं यहाँ पे. तो उनके लिए तो ये एक मेरा मैसेज होगा कि एमएससी को बहुत सीरियस लीजिए और प्रिपेयर करिए और ट्राई करिए कि मतलब फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट और सेकेंड अटेम्प्ट तक आपके पास एक फेलोशिप हो, जिससे कि आप आगे आपके लिए चीजें इजी हो जाती हैं अगर आपके पास फेलोशिप होती है.
एंड फॉर
फेलोशिप नहीं है तभी
एंड फॉर इंटीग्रेटेड आईआईटी एग्जाम को क्लियर करने की कोशिश की, क्योंकि आईआईटी एग्जाम से फिर आप इंटीग्रेटेड में जाते हैं, आरसीबी में आना है तो गैट
एग्जाम तो क्लियर करना ही पड़ेगा. ये इसमें कोई ऑप्शन है नहीं, आपको पूरे कॉम्पिटिशन्स फॉलो करने पड़ेंगे और आपको फिर आगे आना पड़ेगा. फॉर द एमएससी स्टूडेंट, जहां जब भी अभी आप फर्स्ट ईयर में हो, सेकेंड ईयर में हो, थर्ड सेम में हो, अभी से आपका टारगेट होना चाहिए कि आई वांट टू डू रिसर्च. जो मस्ती का टाइम है उसको थोड़ा सा अवॉइड करिए अगर आपका करियर आपको इस फील्ड में बनाना है तो, क्योंकि अगेन वो सेम प्रोसेस आपको करना है, बट आपके पास इंटीग्रेटेड पीएचडी का ऑप्शन अभी नहीं होगा क्योंकि ऑलरेडी यू आर इन एमएससी, तो आपके पास वो ऑप्शन नहीं होता है. तो अब आपको फेलोशिप प्रोग्राम के थ्रू ही जाना पड़ेगा, तो आप पहले वो करिए, ठीक है. और मेरा सजेशन बीएससी और एमएससी सारे स्टूडेंट के साथ ये भी होगा कि जो पोस्ट एमएससी हैं वो भी कि विद द मींस द बेसिक स्टडी यू आर डूइंग, try to learn something new, I can say, as a bioinformatician, I will suggest try to learn some programming language also.
Okay.
Like a Python or R will be great. अगर आप करते हो तो और basic skills like I have seen people here in like integrated PhD program also they don't have basic skill of Excel PPT and all so sometimes they hesitate to discuss these things but मैं ये कहूँगा कि आपको मतलब hesitate नहीं करना चाहिए क्योंकि यहाँ पे सब लोग उसी रास्ते से आए हैं तो एक बार आप जहाँ पे हो जो शर्म आपको लगती है कि पूछने से क्या होगा वो हम फेस कर चुके हैं तो हमें पता है तो आप हमसे पूछेंगे तो आपको आपका मजाक कोई नहीं उड़ाता आपको बताएगा सो अब वो करिए अपनी बेसिक स्किल्स आप इम्प्रूव करिए कंप्यूटेशनल स्किल्स इम्प्रूव करिए जिससे आपका टाइम बचता है आपको पीपीटीज बनाना हो एक्सेल में जो आपको कैसे डेटा हैंडल करना होता है वो जानिए वो समझिए और फिर वही मेरा पर्सनल सजेशन यही है ट्राई टू लर्न एटलीस्ट वन प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज लाइक आर और पाइथन सो आपकी लाइफ बहुत इजी हो जाएगी आई मस्ट टेल यू बहुत ज्यादा इजी हो जाएगी और इसके अगर आपको प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज आती है तो यू हैव ऑप्शन टू चूज अब्रॉड लाइक यू नो फॉर योर पीएचडी आल्सो सो वहां पे उनके प्रोग्राम्स में ऐसा होता है मेरे कई सारे कॉन्टेक्ट में लोग ऐसे हैं जो पीएचडी प्रोग्राम के लिए बाहर उन्होंने अप्लाई किया लेकिन जब वो यहाँ पे थे तो उनको आता नहीं था मतलब ये कंप्यूटेशनल तो I have taught many of them कि कैसे basic programming language के बारे में क्या होता है programming कैसे चलती है क्या script कैसे लिखते हैं basic not the expert level basic कि अगर आपको एक script दे दिया तो आपको पता हो ये script किस program की है और आप उसको use कर सके और run कर सके तो मेरे तरफ से एक message यही रहेगा कि अपने आप को upgrade कीजिए और जो भी कर रहे हैं continue करते रहिए और अपने आपको अपग्रेडेशन के प्रोसेस में एक प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज जरूर जरूर सीखी
सो अगर जो स्टूडेंट्स बीएससी में हैं वो इंटीग्रेटेड पीएचडी पे फोकस कर सकते हैं एज कम्पेयर टू पीएचडी अगर उनको वो शॉर्ट है कि उनको रिसर्च में ही जाना है तो
यस डेफिनेटली डेफिनेटली तो हाँ जो बीएससी में अगर है वो उनको तो कई लोगों को पता ही नहीं होता आई मस्ट टेल यू कि मैंने मुझे पता है कि बहुत को नहीं पता होता क्योंकि आपको अगर ये लोग ये वीडियो देख रहे होंगे तो उनको ये पता होगा कि बहुत इंटीरियर से देख रहे होंगे तो वहां पे उनको कोई गाइड करने वाला नहीं होता कोई बताने वाला नहीं होता सो जब तक उनको पता चलता है वो लेट हो जाता है तो ये मतलब आई मस्ट कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट यू कि आपने इतना अच्छा इनिशिएटिव लिया है जिससे लोगों को पता चलेगा कि या सो मींस कि ये सारे ऑप्शंस हैं उनके लिए तो जो भी जहां पे भी ये वीडियो देख रहा है उसको मैं यही बोलूंगा कि आप जहां हैं जैसे उसमें हैं आप बस अपने आप को फोकस रखिए कि हमें ये करना है अपने फ्यूचर प्लान को बहुत ही क्लियर रखिए और अगर कोई भी आपको क्वेरीज होती है तो आई थिंक बंसल बायोलॉजी इज देयर टू हेल्प यू
सो थैंक यू सो मच अभय आपने इतना सारे पॉइंट्स क्लियर किए स्पेशली इंटीग्रेटेड पीएचडी का And apart from that, all the pointers you have told, I hope students, ye aap logo ke liye bahut helpful rahega. So first of all, Abhay, thank you so much. Aapne itna apna precious time nikala Bansal Biology ke liye aur sare students ke liye.
Thank you, Antika. And it was just a good time for me.
Thank you so all these things. Thank you so much. Sure. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope this video was really helpful for you. If you have any doubt, you can comment below. Thank you so much, guys. Bye-bye. Take care.